हेलो चिल्ड्रंस, इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद द एंगल टुडे वी आर लुकिंग टुवर्ड्स द गेट टू नो योर कंपास. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इफ यू सी हियर देन दीज थिंग्स आर प्रेजेंट इन योर कंपास. व्हाट इट इज, यू नो सम ऑफ द थिंग्स फ्रॉम दिस, दैट इज योर स्केल यू नोज, दैट इज प्रोट्रैक्टर ऑल्सो यू नोज, बट यू डोंट नो अबाउट द सेट स्क्वेयर एंड द डिवाइडर. सो वी विल सी इट्स यूज एंड द अबाउट योर कंपास. Okay, so first of all we will see this is the compass. Compass that we are using for measuring the distance also and to draw the geometric construction. So this is the compass. Here it is shown. It is the place for the pencil. This is the place for pencil. We have to adjust pencil here. Okay, then this is a scale that you are using every day for drawing lines and all. Now this is a protractor. This is the protractor. We are using it for the measuring angle. What is the use of it? That is to measure angle. Measure angle. How much angle we have for drawing angle and for measuring angle we are using this protractor. It has these two zeros. Here it is 10 and here also 10. So that zero is we have to use which zero? The line of angle which we are joining. Suppose we are drawing the angle here. Suppose that is here. This is the arm and another arm is this side. So we have to measure from this zero onwards here. Okay. And instead of that, if you measure, measure this angle from, suppose this is the angle. I will draw here. Okay. So if I will draw here, this is angle and another arm I will draw here, then we are measuring this angle from this side of a zero. Now zero is toward this side, so we have to measure from this side to zero. So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 90. And if you draw the angle from this side, then you have to measure this downside 0 for measuring the angle. Okay. So that is the use of protractor. For what purpose we are using? To measure the angle and to draw the angle. After that, you know about these two things. Okay. These two things are present in your compass and this is called as a set square. One set square is there. Its measure is, suppose if you measure all the angles of this, you will notice that its measure is, this is 90 degrees. Okay. This angle is 90 degree. This is 30 degrees. And that angle is 60 degrees. Okay. So 30, 60, 90. And if you measure these angles of this protractor, this shape of protractor, you will see that it is 90 degree. And this remaining both are 45 and 45 degree. Okay. It is also 45. So these two are there. Look at the two set square. Okay, in the box and observe their angles, try to see how they can be used to draw the angle 90, 30 and 60. So this protractor, if we draw these margins here, you will get the 30, 60, 90 triangle. And if you use this and you just draw the lines from its border, you will get the 45, 45, 90 triangle. Okay, now we will see. And that angles mostly we are using, that two set squares we are using for drawing the perpendicular for the given segment and to draw the 30, 60, 90 triangle and to draw the 45, 45, 90 triangle. Now, this is the divider. You don't know the use of it and we are using it for the comparison of the segment. So, this is the instrument and it is called as a divider and it is used to measure the distance between two points. I will draw. Right, put two points here and if I want to measure, you just increase the distance between this compass and put it on this both, you will measure the distance and you just compare the two segments of different measures, they are equal or unequal. Okay, so that is about the divider. Now we will see how to draw the angle bisector by following some steps. So what is angle bisector? Angle bisector is a line, is a ray. Angle bisector is a ray which is passing exactly from the middle of this angle. Suppose this is angle ABC and its measure is suppose 60 degree. So this is the line angle bisector. I will show it with the different color. So so this is the ray, these two rays, and if you choose, if you want to draw the bisector, then you will notice that this is the bisector and it is passing exactly, if its measure is 60 degree, then this angle bisector is passing exactly at 30 degrees line, okay, of this protractor. Which protractor we have to use for this? This is the protractor that we have to use for constructing angle or to measure the angle. So you just all of you, first of all, this is the compass. This is compass. This is compass. This is compass, scale or ruler, protractor. Use of compass is to draw the angle bisector for the geometric construction. For measuring distance, protractor we are using to measure the angle and to draw the angle. After that, the set square, we can use it for drawing the 30-60-90 angle and 45-45-90 triangle. After that, this is using for drawing the perpendicular for the given line. And lastly, the divider, that is the divider we are using for the measuring the distance between the two points. Now we'll move towards the angle bisector. Okay. Now we will see how to draw angle bisector. For that, we will draw an angle. So this is the acute angle. I am not taking any measure now. So this is angle bisector. Okay. And I have to draw the bisector for it. So for that, what I will do, first of all, take a compass in your hand, adjust the pencil in such a way that it will touches the, put it on the flat surface, and pencil and this metal point of this compass be at the same level. You have to adjust in this way. After that, you have to take some distance. We have to take some distance. It is not have any exact measure. You have to take a distance, sufficient distance. And first of all, I will give name for this. This is angle A, B, and this is C. Okay. Now take a compass, take a sufficient distance, put this compass on point B and draw an arc. Draw an arc. Okay. Now you just change the distance, otherwise keep it as it is. And what happens, we have to put this point on this intersecting point of intersection of arc and the one arm of a angle. After that, draw the arc. Okay. Now put this same point on this point of intersection of arc and other arm of a compass, angle, and draw the arc, intersect the first arc. Okay, now here I got the point of intersection of these both arcs. Okay, now you have to take a scale and draw the line passing from vertex of an angle and a point of intersection of both arcs. Okay, so if you draw this, see here, you will notice that this is the angle bisector. Okay, what it is? It is the angle bisector of a, this is angle bisector. Now I will show you. Well, now we will measure, is it correct or wrong? So first of all, take your protractor, put it on angle B. Now measure the angle, how much it is there. If you see here, the measure of angle ABC is how much it is there. See here, this point we have to take, it is 40 degree. Okay, we have to always measure the angles from the line R of an angle which we are joined to the this side. Okay, so this, from here if you are looking, then its angles measure is exactly, it is 40 degree. And now if you see the bisector, it is also passing from 20, means this is total angle is 40, and it divides it into 20 and 20. So our this angle bisector is at the right position. Okay, now we will see how to draw the angle bisector for obtuse angle. So I will draw an angle. So this is the obtuse angle.
okay. Now same process we have to follow. Take a compass, put it on this vertex. Suppose I will name it as a PQR. This point is P, Q, and that is R. Okay. Now take a compass. Take a proper sufficient distance in your compass. Put this point on Q and draw the arcs on both sides of both arms. Afterwards, increase little bit distance. Otherwise, keep it as it is and draw the arc from this point which joins arc and the arm. And now put it on this side and draw the arc which is intersecting the first. Okay. And now next step is we have to join this Q and this point. Okay. Now we will check our angle bisector is correct position or not. So take a protractor. Again, this zeros line we have to matches to here. So here if you see, zeros are both side. Here it is at down and here it is at above. Okay. So if you join it here, you will notice that the measure of this angle is how much? 120. See here, its measure is 120. And if you see this angle bisector, it is passing from exactly 60. Okay. This is passing from exactly 60. Angle bisector means what? How much is the angle? It's bisector. Means it bisects the angle in equal half. So this is 60. And that is also 60. That we seen about the which angle? It is acute angle. And here it is obtuse angle. And now we will see the how to draw the angle bisector for right angle. So for that, first of all, I will draw the right angle here. So this is my now I will measure the angle here. So I will put it here exactly 90 position, means it is right angle. I think it was over for you. Now I am going to join these two points. Okay, so this angle is angle LMN. This angle is L, that is M, and this is N. Now same process we have to follow. Take a compass, put it on this position, take sufficient distance, draw arc which is touches to the first arm and another touches to the second arm. Okay. Now take this put this point on this arc and you have to draw the arc. And now put it on the another arc. Okay. And now join this . If you measure this, you will notice that it is exactly at 45. Half of 90 is 45. So it is passing from, if you see here, this is 40's line. And after that 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is fifth line it is passing from this. So this is the angle bisector of which angle? That is right angle. Sorry. Okay. In this way, we can draw the bisector of acute angle, obtuse angle and the right angle. After that we will see how to draw the angles of given measures. Okay. Now we will see how to draw angle bisector when the measure is given, measure of angle is given. So first angle is, we will take angle of measure 60 degree. Okay. So this we will take 60 degree. That is our question. Now draw the angle of measure 60 degree. Now take a scale and here draw a one arm of a angle. This is point, suppose we will take as a M. Okay. Now, how much angle we have to take? 60 degree. Now, put this point of joining on this M and just adjust this line of zeros to this line. It overlaps each other in this way. If you see, then this ray and the zeros line is passing from a one, means they overlap one another. After that, how much angle we have to take? 60. Now start measuring from this zero. Okay, always start from zero. Don't count it from this end because our ray is this side of this protractor. So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and here it is 60. Now this line is there. You have to put point exactly on 60 degree. Okay, after this, remove this and draw the ray passing from this point. Okay, this measure is equals to 60 degree. Now we have to draw the angle bisector. So take a compass, same process we have to follow which we have seen. Now put it on M. Okay, after this you just draw the arc passing from this which touches the first arm, and here also which intersect the second arm. So here we will name it as a LMN. So this angle, suppose our LMN. And one thing is that you just use pencil only. I'm using sketch pen because you see it properly, or I'm highlighting this point to you. That's why I'm using this pencil, means different colors, but you have to use pencil only. So after that, take compass, take a sufficient distance that only, and afterward put this pointed arm on this point of intersection of ray and the arc, and draw the arc passing from in between. Now this point we have to put on this and draw the arc which intersect the first arc of this. Now we have to, this is the vertex and this is the point of intersection of arc. We have to join this. Okay, so draw this. Okay, now we will measure our bisector is right or wrong. So just put it on this position and you will notice that 60 is half is 30. So it must pass from 30 degree. If you see here, it is 30 and this angle bisector is passing from 30. So our angle bisector is right. Now we will take one more, and its measure I will take angle, and its measure I will take as a we will take obtuse angle. We will take measure 140 degree. Okay, now we will draw the angle of 140 at first. Same process we have to follow. Draw the one arm of our angle. Okay, so this is our point Y and this is XZ is the arm. Now we have to take how much degree? 140 degree. So take a compass. This point of this 90s line and this downside zeros line, where it is, that we have to put on this Y. Okay. Now how much we have to take? 140. Again we will measure from this side where there is arm. So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120, 130 and 140. So here is the point. So I will plot this point on this 140. Okay, now join this point and the vertex of and this. So this is our angle XYZ. This is angle XYZ. Now we have to draw the bisector for this. Okay, same process. Take a sufficient distance in your compass. Draw the arc. Okay, now just increase little bit distance because this is obtuse angle. Then if it is less distance, then it is difficult to get the point of intersection. So this is first arc we drawn from this point of intersection of this arc and the ray of one arm of her, and from here we will draw the another arc which intersects the first one. Now here is the point of intersection of this both. Now draw this vertex, join this vertex and point of intersection of this both. And now check the measure of angle we from where it is. If you see 140 is half is 70, and you see here it is passing exactly from the 70 degree. So our angle bisector is correct. Now in this way you have to draw this angle bisectors also, which I have drawn already here. This acute, obtuse, and right, and the angles by using the given measure. And now I am going to give you the homework for you. So here, right, draw angle bisectors, sectors for given angle. So first is the, you have to draw it by for 80 degree, second 150 degree, then third 100, take 40, 70 degrees, then third take 160 degrees, okay, and fifth one take as a 90 degrees also you have to practice. Then we will take 40 step and 6. Then 125. You have to practice these angles, all of you. Then we will take here 60 degrees. And one you have to draw with acute angle. Any acute angle you draw. And you draw the angle bisectoring. And last one, draw any obtuse angle which you want, and you have to draw the angle bisector for this. So this is the homework for you. All of you complete and send me on my personal number. Okay, thank you.